started out on a one-way train. Always knew where I was gonna go next. Didn't know until I saw your face. I was missing out on every moment.
I know it's like this right now, right? All right, hello everybody. Welcome back for our special episode of McNeil Moment. Right now we have our three young aspiring poets here who are with us today. Can you introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Charlotte Gustanilla and I'm in fourth grade.
My name is Olivia Robinson and I'm in fifth grade.
My name is Julian Williams and I am in fifth grade.
We are here for a special reason, of course, and there's a reason why you guys are here, because our topic is going to be about poem and poetry. So my first question is, what is poem?
Poem is like a form of art made into different writing.
I think poetry is a way somebody expresses themselves in a lyrical way.
Okay.
To me, a poem is a writing that describes a feeling in a special way.
Why do you think people write poems?
I think people write poems to express how they feel about something or someone. For example, I wrote my poem Still to encourage others to be themselves and to be confident.
So it has a purpose, right?
I think people write poems to show how much somebody means to them. Like my poem, what was my poem? I wish I could remember
my poem, right?
My poem I wish was about things people wish for and they just wish for it. They don't go and try to make it happen. So it's about me struggling and wanting to do something and then I actually get to do it and believe in myself.
That was one of the poems that we did after pandemic, and I think it really kind of touched a lot of people, you know. So, and that, you know, and you wrote it when you were third grade, so you know, it was kind of very kind of awestruck by everybody that a third grader can kind of move and make an impact even to adult.
Which is funny because like you said that we didn't have, as third graders, we didn't have to write the poem.
Yeah.
And
it was just an option at the time.
Whenever they were like reading their poems and I was sitting, I just decided to write a poem in green marker because I got bored. And then I read it and then, surprise, I won.
Yeah, no, that was an awesome moment. What about you, Julian?
I think people write poems to be able to express their feelings in a way that they are comfortable with.
If that's the case, then how do we use the poem in our real life situations? Like, what? How do you find poem? Like, what do we do with it? What's going on with it?
You can apply it to your current situation. For example, my poem still has a line. It goes like this. I am a kid, but I still have a voice. I use this every day. Even if this basically means, even if I'm a kid, what I have to say is important like everyone else, and I have to speak up when something isn't right.
We can spread the word of other people's emotions. Like, if you were to walk in the hallway, you saw a part of a poem Maya Angelou wrote, and it just, like, could inspire people, and you could spread the word of somebody else's work.
Sometimes lyrics and songs sound like poems. Mm-hmm. Songs make us feel things like happy or sad. Songs describe feelings just like poems do.
Yeah, so I always believe that the song or lyrics that we listen to and we read about or we rap about is actually, you know, if you think about it, it's a poem, right? Do you have like a song in your head that you can think of? What is like one song that either gets stuck in your head, or what's the one song that you kind of like? Or it was like one of your favorite songs.
The song is called Warriors. I mean, and then I have another one.
Okay.
It's called Champion. Like, I'm like, me and my dad love this.
We are the champion. Yeah. We are the champion.
I don't.
Not that one. Not that one. Not that one.
What's particularly the reason that you like that song?
Well, this like encourages me to be brave because usually me and my dad. My dad usually drives me to choir on Thursdays, and then we listen to the song. He's like, this is our song. You are a champion, Charlotte. And then I just, oh, I love you, Dad. I mean, it's just really nice.
have a moment to listen with your family, you know, let alone with dad. I think that's a cool moment.
Yeah. Really.
What about you, Olivia? Anything you think of in mind?
Don't look at me.
Ava sings a lot of songs. Your sister sings a lot of songs. I don't know about you, though.
All she sings is Little Mermaid and Frozen.
Well, she likes that song. She's good at it.
No, she doesn't.
What about you, then? What do you like? What can you sing?
A lot.
Hold up. She got a solo in the Christmas thing.
No one needs to be reminded of that, Charlotte.
Wait. You sang something?
Yeah, she sang a solo in the choir.
Wait a minute. You're in choir?
She was in the choir.
You had a solo and everything, and you don't remember?
Oh my gosh, that is.
You had a solo?
Yes. My gosh, it's for it was for the Christmas program at the school.
Oh, I remember my song. It's
Santa Claus is Coming to Town.
That was really.
Well, like,
how come I don't remember?
Because you just don't pay attention to me. It's all about Maddie. Always about Maddie. Because she's your number one chief. And she's always your favorite.
See, I do remember Madeline singing it, but...
Of course you do.
Olivia. At least I remember it.
Okay, so we just found out... I just found out she's in choir. Okay, so then you must have a song that you like.
I just remembered... It's like, it's weird. Like, I don't listen to it often anymore. But it's like Feather by Sabrina Carpenter. I listen to it because whenever I'm mad at someone or they make me feel bad, I just like, I'm just thinking that I don't need them to live. And if they don't like me, then I don't need them at all.
You know, sometimes you listen to a song depending on your mood, right? Yeah, sometimes when you're mad and upset, you listen to something like, you know?
Oh.
And then sometimes, like, you know, when you feel sad or when you want to feel a little sentimental, then...
When I feel sad, I listen to Olivia Rodrigo.
Okay, I get you. Do you listen to Vampire? Oh, I get you, girl. That's... When she cusses, it's like doing that to the person.
What about you, Julian? We left you out there for a while.
I don't have one.
Huh?
I don't have one.
Yes,
you
do.
You don't listen to music.
Old Town
Road,
something.
Stop. Are you in choir?
Last year I was.
Oh, okay. So you were in last year.
Yeah, was I in choir last year?
Yes.
Not you. Him. He doesn't pay attention to me.
I know Madeline was in there.
Okay, Olivia's about to quit. Wait.
Well, you eventually...
Please don't quit.
Eventually, everybody has to quit. You guys are in fifth grade. So you guys only have a month left.
Hold up. That's messed up.
I'm going to remember Madeline, okay?
That's messed up.
Okay.
How's it, Madeline? Really good?
We're all here for a reason, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we're all here because you guys are all winners of the poetry contest that was held on that year. Okay, so it began with Olivia on 2021 to 22, and then we had Julian for 22 to 23, and then we had now Charlotte 23 and 24. What was the most memorable moment in making your video for the poem?
The most memorable moment in making my video was like being able to shoot with my mom. Like, I was really happy that she was able to be in the video. And actually, she comforts me a lot. Like,
mm-hmm.
So that really suited that part. She really suited the role.
I remember, like, kind of really worried about that line you had with the loss of loved one and stuff like that. And I didn't know what to put into it. And I wasn't sure, like, how good you guys are going to act into it. But when you and mom acted out together, it really looked like somebody passed away.
Mom and daughter. I mean, she really comforts me.
Oh, no, it was awesome. That was one of my favorite thing to shoot at as well.
I know, right?
Like, just being able to watch people act out the part mm-hmm. in my poem and, like, hearing that people were inspired by my word
mm-hmm.
Just made me extremely happy because I'm just happy that I get to help people mm-hmm. and people understand what, like, everyone's going through it.
Actually, I got a lot of good response from your poem. When I posted it up on my Facebook post and I saw a lot of comments, it doesn't matter what age it was, like from the youngest to the oldest, like everybody got inspired. And it was something that they said they needed after the pandemic. So it was a really cool moment.
I enjoyed making the video with my friends and remembering my teacher in this special way.
Making the home video, it was supposed to be a simple video. That's what I originally thought. It was supposed to be just a person sitting down and reading the poem. That was it. But we had a lot of friends and teachers and even the parents all contributed one way or another to make the poem really good. And it came out like a masterpiece, all three of you guys. And then the past other poems that we made, you know, to commemorate what you guys have done and the accomplishment and your writing and how it can impact others. I thought that was really special things that we do for our, you know, our community here.
Thank you, Mr. Ian.
How did you feel when your poem was first announced to be produced? Like when I announced this poem is going to be it, how did you feel at the time?
I was really happy. I was so proud of myself. And I was, as you could see in the video where you recorded, I was covering my eyes because I was crying tears of joy, kind of.
Oh, no, like you were surprised, right? Yeah.
I felt kind of nervous because a lot of people would have been able to see it.
Mm-hmm.
And it was for a special person.
How did you feel when your poem was presented in public? As in, when it came out on YouTube, how did you guys feel?
I was, like, ecstatic.
Mm-hmm.
I was really proud of the work that we all put as a team into making the poem.
Mm-hmm.
It's just so amazing how encouragement can spread to others so quickly.
I like the moment that when we first showed it in MCA, like, after the video was done, everybody, like, clapped. Congratulated, you know, like they all gave like a good comment to you. Like I thought that was really cool to see. And then yeah, it was awesome.
But I'm still proud.
Great job, guys. Oh, what about you, Olivia?
Honestly, I felt like a celebrity because I thought I was famous. Especially because, like,
why not, right? You gotta own that special moment, you know?
I felt like extremely happy, especially because I was able to inspire people and to show them that should be yourself no matter what, and you can succeed in anything, because I don't like really show emotion at school, and I was just able to express how I actually felt on the inside and the other part of me that barely anyone's ever seen.
I think it's hard to express ourselves in school. I mean, you know, let alone the students, you know, try to voice their opinions and share their thoughts. I thought in a poem, it kind of expresses not only for the poet, but for everybody, you know, everybody who's in McNeil. Kind of, you know, your poem kind of represents the rest of the student as well. You know?
I felt a little afraid that people would not like it or they would judge it. But I was happy we were able to honor our teacher in this special way.
I'm sure, you know, from down in heaven, I think she's, you know, she's glad and she's happy that, you know, your poem, you know, represented the best part of her.
At moments, but I still smile. I have cloudy
far, far high, away from my kingdom.
You guys have fun today?
Yeah.
We should have a dance party.
Right. Well, dance, lyrics, the songs that we like, I mean, they all come from poetry, right?
Yeah.
To our Merlins, thank you so much for having us. Hope you guys have a great, safe day. Have a good one.
Slay Betty.
Bye.
Bye.
Everybody look to your camera and say bye.
You're slay
bye.
For bye. Watching.
Bye. Oh, wait. Bye.
You're slay for watching. Yay.
Bye. Look forward to my ASMR.
Don't.